In a press conference back in January, Bill Belichick publicly discussed the Patriots' preparation of game balls, which includes a vigorous rubbing or gloving of footballs. Belichick claimed the rubbing process affects the internal equilibrium of the footballs. Here at the Mechanical Engineering Lab at UMass Lowell, Professor David Willis explained the science behind the rubbing process.
So one of the things that the report stated that was really interesting to me was that they actually take off the outer layer of the football, so like a protective coating that gets put on. And different teams prepare the ball differently. So some teams will actually rub it in the dirt after they've taken the protective coating off to rough it up. Other teams will actually rub it with gloves, which is what the Patriots said they did that day. So when you rub the ball with gloves, what tends to happen is there tends to be a friction between your hand and the ball. So if you took this ball and just started rubbing it, your hand would actually get warm. And that warmth is actually going into the football. And the ideal gas law will actually explain that. So as the temperature of the skin of the football increases, that heat is also going into the ball, into the gas, and it's going to cause the gas to essentially increase its excitement or its pressure inside the ball. So the act of rubbing the ball causes the pressure of the ball to increase artificially. And this would be called a non-equilibrium state. So you may have heard that Bill Belichick said that a few times in press conferences, the non-equilibrium state. Basically what they're referring to is the essentially artificial heating of the football due to preparation. So when you rub the ball, it heats the football up for that temporary time. Over time, the football is going to cool off, and it's going to come back to the regular conditions of the rub. One of the things the Wells report did really well was they actually did this and simulated the rubbing of the football, and they used some pretty cool equipment. So they used thermal cameras to actually measure the temperature of the surface of the football to see how much the surface increased, as well as seeing how quickly the pressure in the football decayed after they stopped rubbing the football. So it's actually a pretty big effect when you rub the football. It increases the pressure by about 0.7 psi. The only problem is the decay of the pressure happens really quickly. So in the Wells report, it happened in the order of minutes, not in the order of hours. So something around 15 minutes, which is interesting because what it means is you'd have to be rubbing the ball and then giving it to the official to measure right away, which is unlikely.